if what you want is transportation services from a chunk of land, what's the best way to deal with the biomass, with the plants you can grow on that land? Are you better off converting the biomass into ethanol, using the ethanol as a liquid fuel in internal combustion engines, or are you better off burning the biomass in essentially a combustion power plant, like a coal power plant, generating electricity and using the electricity to run electric vehicles?
And it turns out that you get almost twice as much transportation for a typical vehicle if you're running it on batteries that are recharged with electricity as opposed to running it on ethanol, which is created directly from the biomass. So if you take a hectare of land, which is about 2.5 acres, and you grow some typical grass on that, what we found was that if you took that hectare of grass and you went through the pathway of electricity where you're recharging batteries, you could actually make about 15 trips between San Francisco and New York. So you could go about 60,000 kilometers on that 1 hectare of land with an electric car. If you were to convert that grass into ethanol and try to run a traditional vehicle with an internal combustion engine, you would only get about 9 trips. So it's a significantly greater amount of transportation that you would get from the electric vehicle.
There are 2 basic contributors to this. One basic contributor is that electric motors that can power vehicles are much more efficient than internal combustion engines. And the other important component is that a combustion-based power plant can be very, very efficient relative to the chemical processing that's required in order to convert the biomass into ethanol.
The key idea in this paper is that we really need to be efficient in how we use the land that we're using to grow plants for energy. If you start using some of the best lands, you can potentially compete very, very strongly with food in the sense that you are using land that could have been used to produce food to feed people. If we had unlimited land, we wouldn't necessarily care so much about the transportation per unit land, but since we do have a small amount of land that we really believe could be developed without harming the climate system or the food system, we really need to think about what is the most efficient use of that land.